Hello, and welcome to Plebpla. As you see before you, I have quite a number of models sitting out. I thought I'd take some time and talk about the models that I built in the first third of this year. As you can see, there are 9 of these highly detailed, fun little friends here. And thought I'd talk about, you know, why I got them, how I feel about them, and do my own rendition of a review. I'm not a reviewer, and I'm by far not a professional, but I have built a whole lot of these things. I have almost 150 built and unbuilt, but I digress. We're going to start from the beginning, going from January over yonder to the last one that barely eked it out in April before I started working on both the Deep Striker and the Hamahama. First one over here is the Unit 1 Geminis from G-Unit. These are quite older models, and in one of my very first videos on the channel, I talked about how each of these G-Units had to be modified in order to even put them on a stand efficiently. As such, we had to use the screwdriver method. So these boys ain't coming off anytime soon. For an older kit, the stickers, and I do prefer to use the stickers and decals, already I'm having to push decals back onto the shoulders here. The articulation's kinda weak, but you know, it's a kit that was made back in the mid-90s. And as for why I even have it, I got the Escapulus, and that's got its own little story behind it. But I got the Escapulus, and then the Hydra Gundams. Like, oh yeah, that was in Gundam Battle Assault 2. So I got those two. And at the time that I was getting the Hydra, these were high in reprint. So it was easy to get the other three, and be like, you know what? I got the whole set. Completionist bonus get. And I am a completionist, as we will get to very soon. Next one I'd finished was the Linpulse Gundam over here. The moment that I'd seen this thing announced, it's like, oh, ninjas? I'm in immediately. But then the gimmick behind that was the cowl that turns into the Fuma Shuriken, the giant windmill shuriken. That was just fantastic, and on that alone I had to have the thing. It's as simple as that. Next is the P Bandai Cathedral Gundam from the Build Divers, which I think is very backwards in the way that it had been released and spoken about, because on the wiki page, the Cathedral Gundam is the basis for the Denial Gundam, which was used in that fight against Kamiki from his old, you know, his martial arts senpai, the boy with the Dempsey roll. So it's like, you had the Cathedral Gundam that hadn't debuted anywhere before is the basis for another kit. And even the Cathedral Gundam is its own kit bash of some other stuff that I'm unfamiliar with. But as for getting the thing, it was a lucky find on Gunpla Garage Sale. It's a Facebook group where you can buy, sell, and trade your kits, either built, unbuilt, whatever you like. But it was a lucky find there, and I'd seen it before, and I wanted it simply because of this, the transforming bow gun. I will zoom in, you know, as appropriate per model. Moving on to the next kit is the highly controversial Tristan. The Tristram Gundam. Yes, stay a while and listen to me ramble about how this model it's not that bad. Yeah, it uses a lot of parts from the Alex, and I do have the Alex as well. It's just that limits its articulation, and like, they really could have done a lot better than what they did. It looks alright, but given so many factors, Bandai really got kind of lazy about producing it. Half the runners are Alex, the other half aren't, and it really creates an issue in the stand situation, because I do have this on the U-hook stand, and it's pretty well in there. But if I'm going to complain about it, why bother getting it? Because I'm a completionist. And given that I have at least one model kit per series that exists, and that's breaking it down from like the Seed Side Stories, MSV, Seed MSV, I think I've even got some Unicorn MSV as well, all the little sub-series, and then even stuff like, you know, stuff from video games, I needed to have at least one from Twilight Axis if there were going to be about three kits. The other two, I never bothered to hunt them down since they're P-Bandai, and they all seem to have the same issue of being half super old and half modern. I just didn't bother. And this, it was at a convention, it was there, snatched it up, brought it home. Had a nice day. And the last one I'll talk about in this episode before I get to the latter half is the GM Sniper K9. Ever since this came out, I kind of wanted it. It's always sat on that, I don't know, maybe list. You know, you kind of want it, but it can sit there in the back of the list until, you know, you run out of stuff. And it was cheap. I found it at a local hobby store. And as for some reason, I've always kind of liked Sniper Gundams for just, even though all they do is sit back and they don't have any gimmicks, they have a nice big gun. And this guy has a nice big gun. It's got some transforming gimmicks on it too. But the backpack that goes with it is, you know, enough of an extra cell as well. And I do have the extra little dudes hanging out in the backpack here. Not all of them, but most of them. No, I'm always a sucker for gimmicks, as you'll see on this other half. But that said, we will see you next time. Stay tuned to the end of this video in just a few more seconds, and we will feature more builds from our members in PlugPlaw, the Facebook group, which you can check out also there. Yes, the link in the description below, the Hangar Bay. Thank you as always, and GG up.